Hello and welcome to the second video in our photogrammetry series. In the previous video, we turned our scanned data into a workable mesh ready for texturing. In this video, we will adjust the scanned textures in Substance and export a full set of PBR maps ready for use in Unity's high definition render pipeline. The last step we showed was the creation of some level of detail variations. If we want to further reduce the poly count, we will need to work off of the completed texture and bake it to our low resolution meshes. Our first step then has to be the finishing touches on the maps. Let's fire up Substance Painter. Import your exported FBX or OBJ right into the viewport. Remember to set the document resolution to 4K to match the scanned source dimensions. We will be importing the highest resolution model to bake the highest quality maps possible. Until we create even more LODs, we will be working with the default UVs generated for the mesh. Our first step in Painter will be baking some maps for the smart materials and modifiers to work with. This will enable Substance's smart materials to correctly apply to our mesh and generate the additional maps we need for Unity. Go to your texture settings, set the output size to 4K and bake all maps. Once the maps are baked, we are ready to import our scanned texture to use as a base. To do this, we need to assign our scanned texture to a layer. Select layer 1 and add fill layer. Scroll down to the properties and disable all the material parameters except for one. Be sure to leave color on to actually display the texture. We need to import the texture into Substance first to be able to assign it to our fill layer. Go to File, Import Resources, or simply drag and drop the scanned texture into the Textures folder. Don't forget to assign it as a texture and load it to your current project. Now we can assign it in the color parameter of our fill layer. And there we go. Our scanned texture displays nicely on our model. Now we need to get rid of our untextured border. This is where the power of Substance Painter comes in. We will be clone stamping parts of the existing texture onto the untextured border. Create a new layer and set it to pass through. Now you can use the clone stamp tool to fill in the texture. Be sure to pick areas that transition well into the new border and try to get as few repeating spots as you possibly can. This is also a great opportunity to correct some of the stretched texture parts from our scan. Depending on your scan, you may encounter sunspots or other irregularities in your texture. After you filled up the border, you may want to delighten some details or add in some extra elements. We will be adding some substance materials and layer them with our scanned texture to get a full PBR material that will include all the details from our scan. This will enable us to create a material base that can be shared with other scans or assets and will lead to uniform results when exporting, without relying too much on the scanned texture. We are ready to layer in some fundamental materials now that our border is filled in. For the purpose of this video, we will show you how we layered our materials. How you approach this step is completely up to your project's texturing pipeline or artistic vision. Substance Source is a great library to get solid base materials for your project. There are hundreds of materials ready to download, with adjustable parameters, ready to use in any Substance tool. We used this forest floor as a base to get some extra details in the material, as it matches our scan quite well. For the other layers, we used built-in smart materials and smart masks to get some extra detail in our mesh. We have our forest floor material that covers the whole mesh as a solid foundation. A layer of wood to accentuate the actual stump. A second layer of wood to break up the surface and add some contrast. And the third layer of wood to accentuate the edges. All three are standard Substance presets found in Painter. The combination of these three, layered with smart masks, covers the whole stump to help bring it out from the forest floor. This is how it would look without the forest floor. You can put the wood materials into a folder and save it as a custom smart material, so you can easily reuse it for other tree and wood related scans. The forest floor material is still showing through on the stump, and we are missing some details from our scan, but we will address that in a bit. If you scroll through the material maps, you can see the new details from our smart materials. We could use some extra normal information from our initial scan to enhance some of the details. An easy method would be generating a normal map from the scanned texture and combine it with our final normal map generated in Painter. We will take a little detour and jump into Substance Alchemist for a moment to tell you how you could generate the normal map from the scanned texture and show you the final results of going through this extra step. Substance Alchemist is a powerful tool to quickly generate maps or complete PBR materials. Just drag and drop the scanned texture in the viewport and select Bitmap to Material. You can quickly switch between maps in the 2D viewport to see your changes in action. Select the base layer and choose the best match for your material from the drop-down list. In our case, this is ground. And then adjust the base roughness. This will help Alchemist to determine the output of channels as you add new layers and modifiers. The top layer houses all the parameters to adjust the base output of the material. Height and normal data are easily adjusted with the sliders. There's even a powerful light removal tool at your disposal. We are only interested in the normal map at this moment, so play around with the sliders until you are happy with the results. Alchemist has some powerful modifiers to enhance any material or create new and unique variations with just a few button presses, so be sure to play around a bit. We opened the normal maps in Photoshop, the Alchemist export on the left and the one from Painter on the right. It is immediately clear why we go through the Painter workflow with the display land scans. But a simple overlay of the Alchemist map on top of the Painter normal map will add some small details from our initial scan that are otherwise lost in the Painter workflow. The extra details can highlight some of the unique characteristics from the scan. The differences will become even more apparent in Unity. Let's head back to Painter. The material lacks the details from the scan, but we don't want to overlay the whole scanned texture on top of our detailed smart materials. We will paint in some highlights from the scanned texture to let the unique details pop out. Duplicate the base fill layer with the scanned texture and drag it to the top. Add a black mask so we don't see anything on our mesh. Now we will simply paint in the texture using a white brush on places we would like to have some details. In our case, mainly on the stump itself, edges and some flat spots on the ground floor. Alright, that looks more like the initial scan. You can see the difference between simply setting the layer as a full overlay and painting in some highlights. The material looks washed out with the full overlay. We actually want the material to be a bit darker, so it will hold in Unity's HDRP, where everything tends to white out a little bit. That leaves us with fixing the base forest floor material. It currently shows through the other materials on the stump. We need to mask out the stump. Luckily, we already have a mask of the stump itself. We can copy that mask and simply invert it on our forest floor. And there you have it, a finished material for our little stump. That will leave us with exporting the maps. Painter has a wonderful exporter with a nice little HDRP preset. As you can see, it will pack all the maps in the right channels. You can easily add maps for export and save it to the preset. Thickness maps are quite useful for foliage and cloth. Just create a gray channel, rename it and add the thickness output to the gray channel. You can completely customize the preset to your liking. For our final export, we will double check that the output is set to 4K. Also make sure to set the export output to something like TIFF format so that Painter can compile the maps for you. Select your export location and hit export. If everything finished successfully, you should end up with 3 maps to use in Unity. Our base color with all the texture detail, a crisp normal map, and a mask map, which consists of a RGBA setup and houses the metallic data in the red channel, ambient occlusion in the green, detail map in the blue, and roughness in the alpha channel. With our texture completed, we can now take a look at the LODs again. So far, we have different levels which go down to about 30,000 polygons. If we want to use this asset extensively in a game context, or even on mobile, we have to further reduce this. Up until now, we tried to avoid this so we could still work with the original texture and UV set. If we reduce the poly count further, we will need to create custom UVs and bake the textures onto these new models. As we already said, this process is highly dependent on your own preferences, the target use case and your pipeline. At this point, we will not go into details on how this is done exactly. Leave us a comment if you want to see a more detailed explanation in another video. We ended up with three more LODs. Our new meshes come in at 10,000, 2,000 and a mere 200 polygons. The last one shows really well how far we can break down the model and later add in the details with the textures. In Substance Designer, we create a new substance graph and name it Tree Stump LOD 4, since we will work on the fourth LOD first. You can use any of the templates, as we will not really need to export any of the outputs. In fact, we only use the unmodified baked maps, we do not really need a substance graph at all. Next, we load our base 3D mesh. We can simply link it into our substance project. With a double click on the mesh name, we can open it in the 3D view. We do the same with the model for our fourth LOD and the maps we exported from Substance Alchemist. In the 3D view, we can already see the extreme difference in detail. To get those details back, we will now bake the information from our high-resolution model to our new level of detail. To do this, we open the baking dialog from the right-click menu by selecting Bake Model Information. On the right side, we can see our newly arranged UVs. On the left side, we need to set up our high-definition mesh. We simply select it from the resources. Now we can add a baker to the list. The first one is Normal Map from Mesh. Next, we need three bakers of the type Transfer Texture from Mesh. These will project the maps we created earlier from the high-resolution mesh to the LOD mesh. Simply choose the maps in the texture file slot from the resources. Once you assigned all three maps to the bakers, hit Start Render. If you see any holes in the created map or during the baking process, you need to adjust the frontal and rear values. These will need to be higher, the more the reduced mesh differs from the high resolution mesh. Before you leave this dialog, you can save the preset to make it easier to do the other LODs. To check our material, we drag the resulting maps into our graph and look at the result in the 3D view. At this point, we can reintroduce a few details from the normal map we got off the high-resolution mesh if we want. This helps to mitigate the loss of finer detail in the geometry. Just do not forget to export the result of the normal blending if you intend to use it. We can now repeat this for the other LODs we created. When we are done, we should have three sets of textures for each of the new LODs. To conveniently use them later, we will rename them now. This will be it for today. Please join us again next time, where we will show you how to set up our asset in Unity with LODs and corresponding materials. And be sure to check out our extra video, where we will show you how to set up a good-looking scene in Unity's high-definition render pipeline. This video was made in cooperation with the federal state initiative GameUp Rheinland-Pfalz. Thank you for watching. As always, if you enjoyed this video, you can subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave a comment.